Assalamu alaikum students, welcome to mathematics online class. Today's topic is compound 3D solids. In our previous classes we are dealing with 3D solids and we are asked to find the volume and surface area of 3D solids. In this class we will be dealing with 3D solids, but this time our shape will be a compound 3D solid, means our shape will have more than one 3D shape. It can be a combination of a pyramid or a cuboid. It can be a combination of a hemisphere or a cone. It can be a combination of a hemisphere or a cylinder. So in this topic we will be dealing with more than one 3D solid. So it's not that much hard if we have memorized the formula for the 3D solid well. We can use those formulas, but the formulas are no different. The formulas are the same. But the only different thing is that we will be dealing with more than one 3D solid at a time. So the task is the same. We have to find the volume and surface area of our compound 3D solids. The volume strategy is not that much, you can say, difficult. We just have to identify how many 3D solids or 3D shapes are there in our compound shape. And we just have to use their formulas. And we have to find their volumes individually and then add them to get the total volume. For example, if our question has a hemisphere and a cone, so we will be using the formula for the hemisphere, that is 2 upon 3 pi r cube, and the volume of the cone, that has a formula 1 upon 3 pi r square h, and we will find their individual volumes and then add them to get the total volume. If the question is asking us for the remaining volume, so we will be subtracting both the volumes. It depends upon our question. So the trick for this questions is that you have to memorize the formulas well, and you have to identify the type of shape, the type of 3D solid which is present in the compound shape. And fortunately the questions which we will be solving will have been mentioned in them, that which type of 3D shape is present in the compound shape. So it will not be that much difficult. You just have to read the question carefully, identify the shapes, 3D shapes, and then use their formula, find their volumes individually, and then add them to get the total volume. For surface area, the surface area is quite similar to perimeter, which we did in the 2D shapes. The perimeter is the outside boundaries, the surface area is exactly the same. We just have to walk on the boundary of the compound shape and see what type of surfaces are there on our path, and we just have to consider only those surfaces which are outside the boundary, not the inside surfaces, and we have to find their surface area by using their formulas, and then we will add them to get the total surface area. We have to split the figure. The trick to find the surface area is that you have to split your figure into different diagrams. For example, if my 3D solid is like a rocket, so I will split my diagram. I will draw it in parts. The first part, as I have discussed over here, the first part will be upside down V, and that is basically the curved surface area of a cone, and that has a formula pi r l. Then we will have two parallel lines, or the curved surface area of a cylinder, which is which can be described by the formula 2 pi rh. And then there will be a circle at the bottom which has the area pi r square. So when I will be able to draw my diagram in different parts, I just have to use the right formula for every part, and I have to find the surface area for each part, and then I will add all the areas to get the total surface area. So in order to find the volume and surface area, the most important thing is the formulas. You have to use the right formula at the right place. For the volume, it will be mentioned in the question that what type of shapes are there, so it will not be that much difficult. But for the surface area, you have to draw your diagram, you have to split your diagram into different parts, and then you have to use your formula, find the surface areas, and then add them to get the total surface area. Inshallah, we will be solving some questions on this topic and your concept will be more clear.